Alright guys, so I'm going to be showing you all the fastest way to clean a sheep's head, okay? In my opinion, okay? People have plenty of opinions out there. I'm not saying you have to do this. If you don't like it, you don't have to do it. This is just the easiest way that I find cleaning a sheep's head. So what you're going to do first is you're going to get a little flayed knife just like this. This is actually a new bubble blade that I got for Christmas. And what I'll do is I'll just go ahead and start like this. Kind of cut my way like that because I got a lot of head meat. And then it's just like any fish, so what you're going to do is you're just going to follow the rib cage down like so. Or not the rib cage, but the backbone. You're just going to follow it down the bone just like that. Just like that, so right there. And then you're just going to come through here and do that. Now I'm actually missing a little bit of meat. I'm not used to this one. Let's switch knives. So then you're just gonna do just like this. And then whenever you get to this back part, what I like to do is I like to just go ahead and bring my knife all the way through just like so. And then, so then you can pick it up like this. And then you do the same thing for this bottom part. What you do is you just peel it up. Because if you're trying to do it like this, it's that backbone will get in the way. So what I like to do is I like to pick it up like so. And I do the same exact thing. Just like right here, you're doing the same thing right here. And you're just following that cage. Following all those ribs, just like so. And then as you can see, I mean, it gives you a beautiful, beautiful flay. And be careful with your thumb. I don't recommend holding the flay like this, but just because I don't really have anywhere else for it to be right now. So then as you can see, there is a lot of meat right there, just like that. So that's a pretty well filleted sheep's head. Obviously there's a little bit of meat left still, but that's a given. So that's what it should look like. Just a beautiful rib cages on both sides, just like that. And then this is the easiest way. This is what makes these things so much easier, okay? So a lot of people will try to force their way through the rib cage with the bubble blade or any type of flay knife. So don't even waste your time trying to cut through these rib cages with the flay knife. You're not, I mean, you'll get through them, but it's just gonna make it a pain in the butt. So what I like to do is get a pair of pliers. Any pair of pliers, just a cheap pair. And what I like to do is right in here is where all those rib cages are. And this is not gonna affect the meat at all. So what I like to do is take my pair of pliers just like so. And I like to stick it in there, just like that. Stick the pliers in just like that. And then grab it and then just twist just like so. And then move down a little bit further, squeeze and then twist. And what you're doing is you're just breaking all these bones, so that way you don't even have to worry about cutting these things out. Because let me tell you something, they are a pain in the butt to get out. And then see, right now I just broke all the rib cage. I just broke all the bones. And then what you do now is you just get your flay knot like so, and then you just come like down just like so. And then you try not to cut a stomach, like I just did, but come like so. And then this part right here, this cuts like butter. So then you just sit right here and you just cut it just like so. And that right there is a perfect sheep's head flay. And I kind of messed up in the beginning. I didn't really get as fine of a cut as I like, but I mean, that's plenty good enough. I mean, there's hardly any meat on the bones right there. So now what we do obviously is you just cut the rib cage out. So what we'll do is we'll fill around. Every fish has got a different rib cage. These have really profound rib cages. They're extremely, extremely bony fish. So what we'll do is we'll fill, try to save as much meat as we can. And honestly, what I like to do is I like to actually cut it close and then I'll just cut them out. What I'll do is I'll just come back and cut them out if I still feel them. But I like to get as much meat as I can. So right there, the rib cage is out, but there's still some bones in here. I just like to get that out of the way for right now. And some people actually pick these off with their like fingers and stuff like that, but what I like to do is just cut them out. So we'll feel, there's one right there. There's one right there. So I think that's just about it. And then what I do is I'll just, so I just made two slits right here, right here. That should be enough. Then what I'll do is I'll come right here, and I'll just cut that piece of meat out, like so. And then it's still attached to the skin, which is why it's having that kind of problem, but... And then right there, that's one of your bones. And then just like that, that is a sheep's head fillet. Beautiful, beautiful sheep's head fillet. And then the last part, what we'll do is right here at the very end where the tail is, we'll just make a little cut, just like this. And then grab it with your fingernails. And then what you'll do is you'll just grab it just like this, and we're actually gonna switch because that blade's not long enough. We don't wanna lose any meat. So what we'll do is we'll get the other Bubba blade out and just follow it down. Just like so. And then the more that you cut it, the easier it'll become, because then you can grab more of the skin. And you just cut it just like so. And then that right there is a sheep's head fillet. And then some people like to also cut out the bloodline, but this guy doesn't really have too much of a bloodline, but you can always come in here and just kind of, you know, obviously you can just cut it like that. That's a slab of meat, and then you can just kind of come through here and skim the bloodlines out, because people say that makes the fish bitter, but I normally keep them in there. I'm just doing this for video purposes, but there you go. That right there is your sheep's head fillet. And I hope this helps. I mean, I know it's kind of simple. It's kind of like flaying any other fish, but I feel like that plier method really, really helps. So since the fish is actually cut open now, I'll go ahead and explain. This will be a lot easier. So if you want to come over here real quick, I'll give him a closer look. So what you do first is you cut up just like this, cut up to the head meat, and then you go and you make an incision all the way down his backbone, like so. And then what you're gonna do is you're gonna fold that fillet up. You're gonna fold that fillet up like so, and you just follow it along the backbone. And then whenever you get done, you're gonna do the same thing down there. And then at the very end, all this will be cut out. You'll have your whole fillet, but it'll still be attached to the backbone. And then that's whenever you come in here and you keep them wide, and you close and you twist. And that'll break that section. Do the same thing. Move over a little bit, squeeze, twist, break that section. Come down here one more time, squeeze, twist, break that section. Then all you do is cut through the stomach, which is soft, and there you go. That's your sheep's head fillet. I hope this helps. If this video did help you guys, make sure to subscribe. I got a lot of videos with me fishing out of here in Pensacola, Florida. And yeah, I will definitely make more how-to videos in the near future. And like I said, if this video helped you out, make sure to leave a like and subscribe for more videos.